I'm Andrew Helvers. I'm an applied physicist. I work at Thorlabs, and here we're presenting a flexure stage that is voice coil actuated, here shown being incorporated into a Michelson interferometer. Voice coil refers to a technology in which you have a permanent magnet and an electromagnet, where you apply a voltage to the electromagnet and you can get these attractions and repulsions between the two pieces, so you can convert a voltage into a motion. The flexure is something that's relatively long-lasting and works fairly well for small motions, which in this case we're aiming towards mid to low resolution spectrometers as our application for this particular product. This is different from other products that we have that are other stages because this allows for very easy small motions that are very smooth. As we went through the process, we sort of refined things. One of the things that took a while to develop was the flexures themselves, because we wanted to make sure they'd have a very long life and also not have an excessive amount of motion in yaw or pitch. And in order to do that, we had to make a structure where the center of the flexure is stronger, stiffer than the edges. So most of the flexure motion is happening at the edges of the flexure. This product's capable of being run in both an open loop and a closed loop mode. For open loop, there's no feedback mechanism to make sure the speed stays constant. You just put in a waveform and hopefully you found a good enough waveform and have minimal vibration in your environment so that it does have a reasonably smooth motion. That does have the advantage that it's very easy to implement, but it does have the disadvantage that if you have a lot of vibration or extremely demanding in how stable the motion is, it may not work well enough for that application. Closed loop refers to the idea that you close a loop and have a feedback loop where you have some kind of tool to measure the position of the stage or the speed of the stage so that it maintains a particular performance. This does not have an encoder included, so what you would have to do is implement something like we have here, where there's a laser that is being used in the interferometer as a reference laser, and we make corrections to the speed and the waveform based on a signal we get in the interferometer coming out from that reference laser. I would probably think the most likely alternate application would be as a delay line. So in a delay line, you often have something like a pulsed laser where you're trying to change the arrival time of a pulse relative to another pulse. And with something like this, you can very smoothly change an amount of delay. We're attempting to target markets for do-it-yourself interferometry or cases in which someone might want to incorporate this into another product as sort of an OEM component, where the goal that we had in mind was low to mid-resolution FTIR spectrometry. So you could do measurements in the mid-IR to try to do chemical signatures and that sort of thing. Thorlabs has had this emphasis on having a large catalog of parts for someone who wants to consider doing a do-it-yourself route, so I feel like that's keeping with a lot of our philosophy and spirit.